going on. It is Purdue here, and I want to bring you guys a brand new series that I think we can really get into. I think we're going to call it Purdue's Playbook, because guys, I've been telling you, I have so many different formations in place in my Ravens playbook that I can run at different defenses that I think I should slowly, one by one, start breaking them down for you guys so you guys can start running them too. Because I know a lot more people I've seen online and other people's videos have been running Ravens playbook and have been running especially the Heisman formation. So I think I'd like to hope that I may have inspired a few people to start running this. So I want to continue to do that. So I'm going to break down for you guys, say how you would run the Heisman formation to its fullest potential. Okay guys, so here we are. We're going against the Seattle Seahawks defense because I feel they're one of the best defenses to go against in head-to-head to show you guys that this actually is a really effective offense. And for your personnel, personally, how I run it in my ultimate team is I like to have fast break on my Michael Vick at quarterback because it does make such a huge difference for when you're taking different angles on triple options and power options. And I'll have a trick play at the end that you can run if you have fast break. But one of the main necessity abilities I feel, which most people do have, but you really do need, is running back apprentice. And the reason is because man coverage is so meta, it allows you to add so many different styles of passing plays and concepts into this formation. So if you do have a running back apprentice, running back, I would say put it at this right running back spot right here. So you want to take off the Heisman formation. When you first go to the Heisman formation, you want to take Heisman off. So you flick the right stick when you're looking at the formation and you just want to sub in both your running backs. So I have Alvin Kamara and Montgomery for the Saints. So you want your second running back in at the second spot here. So if you run a triple option, Alvin Kamara would be the give and Montgomery would be the pitch man. Also, you want your best route running receiver out on the left side here because there's a double move that we can show you guys to beat man coverage. You want your best route running receiver out here. Ideally, you want them to have as many of the route running thresholds as they can get, but for sure you want the deep running threshold. I have Lynn Swan out here in my ultimate team. You guys see on the double move, he usually hooks people, especially with his speed. So to start out, I want to show you guys a passing play here. So we're going to go out. There's only three plays in this formation. So I know it's not a lot, but it's easy. You don't have to set your audibles, and there's a lot you can work out of it if you get really creative. And if you guys start having like hot route master quarterbacks and stuff, you can really scheme some stuff up. So this is what the play looks like as base. And the way Kamara works is it play actions off your triple option. So it's really interesting. So what I like to do if we were playing against a cover two here, which is what I got started up to, which is the defense I have. I want to go against a nickel 3-3-5. Again, very common defensive formation, but I want to go against all different types of defensive sets. So you'll see here, we're going against a nickel 3-3-5. What I want to do is streak my tight end and Jared Cook. So it's going to take away this free safety, or strong safety, sorry, which looks to be Jamal Adams at the moment. I then want to motion over Michael Thomas. So that double move is going to really split these zones on the right side. Now, either if you don't have a running back apprentice or if you want to keep that play action there, what I recommend you do is you can put Montgomery on an out route. So now you have a full flood concept and you have a check down with Emmanuel Sanders on the hook route, which is part of the play, and you have a good play action to Kamara, which is also a little dump off if they send heat. So I'll show you guys what it can look like this. We initially want to see if we can hit Michael Thomas up on the sideline, and you guys will see here, Michael Thomas is wide open. Taysom Hill doesn't have the best arm, so it's going to take a long while to get there, but when you guys have good quarterbacks, that ball will get there quick. So another way you can run this play, which I personally like to do, especially with the running back apprentice, is you can streak your tight end, motion your receiver over just like we did, but instead, if you want for extra protection against blitzes or other checkdowns, you can block your triangle running back and use your running back ability on Kamara to put him in a flat route. So now you have a quicker dump off route for over there. If you also want, you could put like Emmanuel Sanders on a deep in maybe for a delayed and then curl route Montgomery. You could try something like that. But even still, you can look for Kamara at the backfield, but ideally you want to try and hit Michael Thomas up the sideline there because the cover two half will not play it, especially because it'll be distracted by that tight end streak route. So that is the first play I wanted to go over with you guys. Okay guys, so another one you'll see, because this is Madden 21, we have the man coverage made of this year. So here I'm going to go against a cover one. And the reason is I ideally want to hit Michael Thomas on this double move. And most people are going to start putting their guys in curl flats and stuff. They're not going to be playing them over the top. Or if they do, you're going to have other things get open. So again, you can mix up with different routes. But what I like to normally do to start off is curl route my tight end for a low ball curl if there's nothing else open. This is where you need running back apprentice, I swear, for the man coverage. To beat it, you put him on that Texas route, so it's going to be a nice angle route. Then personally, if they're blitzing, I like to block triangle so I get a little extra protection. But if it's a cover one and you know you're going to get a bit of time, put him on an out route. It gets good spacing and it's a good low check down to beat backers. So here it's a cover one, they're not expected to be blitzing, so we're going to do that. Finally, I like to put Circle Montgomery on a slant route. So again, it's all good man-beating spacing routes. But the final step, it's not a route changing, but you want to motion snap Michael Thomas. And the real key thing is here, you want to snap the ball while he's in motion, so he's going to get the speed burst, and you guys will see it when he first takes off on the route. And to do that, on our right tackle, you see there in our tight end, Jared Cook, the little gap between them. Technically, Jared Cook isn't actually lined up a tight end. So if you guys have a tight end apprentice, it won't activate there, unfortunately. But what that does mean for Jared Cook is you can put him on different routes that you normally couldn't as a tight end. But really, because he's in the gap there, you can snap the ball while he's in between there. So you want to try and, so I'm going to motion Michael Thomas over. I want to snap the ball right in between my right tackle and my tight end, Jared Cook. And you're going to see he's going to get a beautiful speed boost. And we're going to look to absolutely torch him on the sidelines. With a better quarterback, you can pass lead it upfield and you will get a touchdown. If you guys watch my gameplays, I kill defenses with this every time with Lynn Swan. We're going to go back to it. You guys will see again. So that's the, we're going to go PA wheel, and you guys can see it doesn't take too long to do the adjustments. I already have it set up there. So again, we're just going to motion Thomas over. There's the player, and we want to snap this ball right now. And you're going to see the speed burst he gets on that first move, and you want to launch that ball up, baby. And okay, I don't know why he didn't react there, but you guys see it is wide open. It is an absolute torch of a play. Okay, guys, let's say they're playing deep pass over the top. There are different ways to attack this. Other ways I like to do is instead of motioning Michael Thomas and putting him on the double move, I put him on a curl route, and I actually like to do Jared Cook on a slant. That works really well too. So after all the adjustments, we basically get a concept like this. So sometimes I will leave the command route, or it can get a bit, it can get clustered in there. So I'll put sometimes Cook on a drag instead. Or again, to mix up, if they're using the Kamara route, you can leave Cook on a slant and just put Kamara on a flat route instead. So their user will break in because they're expecting that little Texas route, and they're just going to go to the flat. So even still with this, you guys will see my tight end is usually what I like to hit, and Jared Cook is fast enough, he'll get open. I run Eric Ebron in my offense, so with 91 speed, he does get open. I love having Eric Ebron as my number one tight end. But guys, what the main thing is, which people want to do in this formation, is run. So that is the key here. I want to go over you guys how you're going to run the ball. And the key thing is here, guys, in option football, remember, especially on triple, or okay, let's start off with read option. When there's a read key, you're not blocking that guy. If there's a triple option, it's a read key and a pitch key. So you're not blocking two guys. You have the numbers already. Think about it. There are 11 guys on offense and 11 on defense. Your quarterback takes up one, sure, but you are not blocking two guys on a triple. That means you have two free blockers. You have the numbers. It's 9 versus 11. It's fine. So trust me, you want to try and figure out when you have to give the ball off in the box on the give on the triple, how can we get the best blocking on the interior? Because that's what people want to do. People put their option defense to conservative. You want to be able to get good blocks on the give. That's why I have postable abilities. But the key way to do it is you guys will see here. If I come out in my Heisman option, you'll see my read key and my pitch key are the corner and safety. I don't like that. Most people will press down their defense and they're going to start bringing safeties down like this. But guess what? If we go back here, who's my read key? I have the corner as the read key and the pitch key is the linebacker. I still don't like that because we don't have enough blocking on number advantage in the inside of the box. So what you want to do here is motion your tight end out. Now you have the read key be the D end. So your tackle is leaving the D end. He's going to get straight up to the backer and you're going to get much better flow to the left side, I promise you. And the key thing is here, the pitch key is now the safety. A lot of people will use that safety, or they'll put them in that deep route over top, the deep halves, because of that double move we talked about, and they won't put them in a QB spy or a flat. If they do, they're gonna play your pitch really aggressive. But let's say they have them in, let's say they're using him, okay? Let's say they wanna play your give. You can do what's called a pull and pitch here. So we can pull and we're gonna pitch this ball immediately. Let's say you can't really control what the DN does. I want him to play Taysom Hill there, but if he does and the safety's backed off, who's the pitch key, you can pull and pitch it immediately. I'm hoping to see if we can do the same thing here. I'm hoping the DN will play me, but again, the key thing we said here with this play in the Heisman option, the first audible you have, is you want to motion Cook over, and that will make the safety the pitch key, and you see the DN the read key. Alrighty guys, we actually fixed it now. So we put the option defense on conservative, which most people do. So we're going to play it. Most people like to use this safety, or they're going to put him in a deep half to defend that double move like we said. So we're going to pretend like he's being used out of the play. So again, guys, because the option defense is going to be on conservative, they're going to play our QB. So that's going to lead into other formations we can run against them, but we're sticking to this one. So again, like we said, we want to motion out Jared Cook. So now you see the D end is the read key, and the pitch key is the safety. Now, ideally in real option football, and depending on how the defense plays it, you're going to see when the read key is going to squat and play my QB, I'm supposed to give this off. And because we motion out and that read and that D end is on the read key, you guys see we get great blocking onto the backers immediately. But if you have to be really good at your read here, because it can be very costly if you get it wrong. If they're really worried about that double move and they're keeping this guy in a deep half, or they're not keeping, if they're putting him in a deep half where they're usering him and they want to play the give and they scream over this way, you can try and do what's called a pull and pitch. And what you're going to do is as soon as you snap that ball and that DN starts to squat on you, you are spamming L1 to get that pitch out. What's going to look like is this. So I have to use your both controls. It's going to be hard. We're going to say, okay, the user went over to play the give, and you just spam that L1 to get that pitch out. And you hope your tight end picks up the block, but the pitch key is now out of the play. If they leave him in a deep half, like I'll try and show you here, it works most of the time, they'll drop off as the pitch key, and they're not going to play the proper run assignment. So you can just get a quick pull and pitch and get a few easy yards. And guys, these aren't necessarily 10, 20 yard plays. We're fighting for 4 or 5 yards at a time. That is option football. So you guys are gonna see here, boom, squats, pitches the ball out. The safety's way upfield, not being able to make a tackle until I get 6 yards already on the play, guys. That is option football. You gotta be smart. You gotta make reads before the snap and set it all up. It's nice to run shoot clock sometimes and kill the clock, but a lot of the time it takes too long to set your plays up to do that. And again, the best part about all of this is based on your personnel, you can audible into so many other formations, which is what I'll break down in other videos for you guys. But really, this is the main way that you want to play this, guys, is motion this tight end out for the triple option. And that way you're going to be able to give this ball off when you need to, and you're going to get great blocking on the interior, and you will be able to take this to the house a lot of the time. If you guys want to see it happen in game, go watch my gameplay. This is the offense we run, guys, and honestly, it does work effectively. Now, for the last part of the video I want to show you guys, if you do have fast break, this is what you're going to want to do. Alrighty, guys, so this is the play I want to break down for you. So again, before I forget, big nickel defense is a very popular defense we also go up against, but here you can run a full flush triple option. Again, you motion the tight end out and you will get great blocking. Here you want to keep with Lamar Jackson. We're able to run a triple option perfectly there. Guys, if we go to the replay, I want to show you quickly. This is how a triple option is properly done. You see, I'll pull it up. When we go to give this ball off, our linemen are going to surge. Now, the one thing I forgot to mention, when you run this play, you're going to want to ID this backer as the mic. And the reason for that is because most of the time when you're going to have to give this ball off, your guys will no longer double team this D tackle. Instead, your center will overtake him and your guard will scream up to this backer and block me immediately. For me, it's John Hanna, and when I have these nasty streak abilities on him, it usually gives a good significant block that if you want to bounce it to the outside, your receiver just got to hold on for half a second here and you are gone. But here you see, because we didn't have the adjustment set up, the D end actually crashes in on the pit, on the give. So it's now up to us to read this pitch key. Here you can clearly see he eventually commits to Lamar. So we're just going to pitch it outside and we have incredible room. And look at this. This is what's also glitchy about this year, which they didn't do in years past. Quarterbacks actually get upfield with you and will attempt to lay a block. I have had Michael Vick lay so many clutch blocks for me in clutch games where we get first downs that we really didn't deserve to. But guys, the main play I want to show you, what you need the fast break ability for, is if you go into your audibles and you call the shovel option, it's designed to go to the right. But if you see here on the left side, the D end over 78 will be blocked because he's not that far outside. And also there's only two people above our receivers. That means everyone has a man blocking them. And the point of this is to have the fast break ability allows you to go outside whichever way you want on designed quarterback runs. So we're just gonna take this, get in behind 27, Dobbins our running back, and just get straight to the left. So watch this, snap the ball and just get straight outside, guys. Use that speed to get outside. And you can even spin move, juke move. I do this with Vic all the time. 95 speed kills online. People do not know how to defend this because you can go back and right, left, right, back and forth, whichever direction you want with Lamar Jackson. It's really insane. The other one I like to do is you can motion your tight end out. And again, you need fast break for this. But again, it's kind of hard here. It won't always work, but this is good for 1-2 yard gains. You have to wait and sit for a half second, let your guard pull and get in behind him. And you can just get straight up field and get a great gain then with Lamar. The pitch keys will often be too slow to react and they'll be busy with something else. If you get right tight up field in that A gap, just again, I'll do it one more time. half a second just behind your guard and just get straight up field behind his ass. You will get such great blocking, guys. I promise you. I want to go and do this a regular series, guys. We're going to break down all the formations I run. I have, honestly, I want to say 15 different formations, and I have a full set of plays of all of them. So I want to say I have over 50 plays at least, guys. Like, this playbook is massive when I want to run to my fullest. This is the first formation I want to break down for you guys. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video, and I'll leave you with another Lamar run to end it. I'll see you boys next time.